Welcome to Unlock Layouts. In this video, we are going to discuss the continuity of high and low voltage LD MOSFET layout design. So this is the part 2 video. Before I have uploaded the part 1 video for the basic understanding of LD MOSFET design and as well as the cross-sectional view design. So this is the continuity of my first part. Let's start the video. Initially, we will see how many types of devices are available in LD MOSFET fabrication design and what are all the difference between the device to device, like each and every layer wise and cross sectional view wise and layout wise. So each and every layer, everything. Okay, so we will discuss one by one. So initially, I just wanted to show you some of the device names here. So this is our library. So in our library, we have a normal MOSFET, like we have a low voltage MOSFETs. So low voltage MOSFETs are available and as well as high voltage MOSFETs are available. Both MOSFETs are available here. See, low voltage MOSFETs, like for example, this is our typical MOSFET. So typical MOSFET is nothing but whereas we are using our normal planar MOSFET without any like higher voltage rating. So we'll get our source terminal, drain terminal and as well as our gate terminal. So we don't have any other, you know, external layers or like extra layers, okay, because these voltage will work for only 2 voltage, because since they have mentioned NMOS for 2, so the operating voltage of these NMOSFET is only 2. Okay, so we have a 2 voltage device also available in this LD MOSFET fabrication device. Then we'll go for the higher voltage rating device. So this is N channel voltage. So this is N MOSFET with 5 voltage of the biasing signal. So let's try to open and I'll show you the layout. So if you open this NANCH, so this is NANCH device 5 for BASO. So I don't know what is the exact extension for this BASO. So if you open the P cell itself contains some guard ring. So generally what we will do in the normal planar MOSFET, like typical devices, manually we will add this guard ring. Okay, so like P well or P MOSFET, one MOSFET, according to the P MOSFET and N MOSFET, we'll add like P substrate ring or else N substrate ring. But here, so this is your P cell. The P cell itself consists a local guard ring here. So apart from this local substrate, we have to add the additional rings, like what we discussed in the earlier, like deep envelope ring and as well as N buried layer ring and as well as our global substrate ring. So apart from that, we have to add 3 rings next to next level layers of this, you know, like local substrate ring. So that I'll show you in future. So this is how the one more the normal devices structures will be there in the LD MOSFET. And then, so apart from that, whatever devices here available, all the devices will have like same kind of structure apart from these GBMAC devices. So these GBMAC devices also have the same structure, but you know the distance between the source terminal to the drain terminal. Okay, so the distance between the source terminal to the substrate ring, so will be like more than 2.5 micrometers of distance, exactly from the OD to this OD. So they have 2 micrometers of distance. So in order to prevent unwanted leakage and unwanted, you know, like higher voltage rating problem, related problem like cross coupling capacitance, leakage current. So for all those things, the local substrate ring itself has to be placed 2 micrometers of the distance away from our OD. Okay, so this will try to give lot of, you know, lower well resistance, because since we have extended the longer distance from our substrate ring, so this will give like more protection with respect to the leakage current and leakage voltage. So this is how the normal structure will be there for the LVT GBMAC devices. So this device also going to work for 5 voltage. Okay, so 1.2 voltage is the 1.2 to 1.6 is the VT. So source and drain voltage rating is 5. So let me close this and let me show you how the high voltage MOSFETs will be there in the LD MOSFET structure. So we have so many types of devices available in this library. So we'll try to explore one by one. So initially we have this devices. So this device name called NA6G5A with NBuried layer with MAC layer. So I'll just try to open a symbol for this device. See here in our symbol, we have a gate terminal here and we have a source terminal here and we have a drain terminal here and as well as we have a local substrate. So this is our body terminal. Apart from that, we have a one more substrate, you know, terminal is available. So totally we have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terminals or 5 connections are available in these devices, which means this is, you know, like 5 terminal devices. So that's why they are mentioning GA5. So GA5 is nothing but 5 terminal devices. Then we need to add one more external ring to the devices. So let me open and let me show you the layout view of this device. So this is how, you know, like the structure, internal structure of the device will be there. So initially, as we discussed, we have a HV envelope. The first layer here, it is showing HV envelope. So this is our HV envelope. Then we have our diffusion. So our active diffusion is here. Okay, so next to that active diffusion, the active diffusion is laid under the HV envelope. So these red color line, whatever it is there. So this is our HV envelope layer. Then we have a poly. So we have a 2 polys here. Okay, so poly contacts here. So this is our gate contact. Then we have a P implantation. So here they have, you know, like added one more P implantation. Internally, they have added one more P implantation. And then we have a one more N implantation. So the complete source drain, everything will be under the N implantation devices. Then we have a RPO layer. See, RPO layer is exactly added here, the green color one. Hope you know, like you can able to see very clearly the green color layer. Let me show only RPO layers. So these RPO layers, then we have a diffusion. So this is our drain terminal. Okay, so this is our drain terminal. Initially we have a drain terminal. So next to our drain terminal, so they have a RPO layer. So this is our resistor protective layer. So what does it means? If you have a RPO layer here, see, this RPO layer will prevent from silicidation. If the silicidation process is not, you know, happen here in this particular area, the sheet resistance of the OD will be very high. So which means the particular area, whatever here, it has a high resistance. Okay, so only this particular OD area will have a high resistance. Apart from that, this source terminal will have very low resistance because they don't have any RPO layer. So silicidation process will happen on top of this OD layer. Okay, so this is how the RPO layer will be formed and will be like one more additional mask. Okay, if you want to fabricate this RPO layer, so this is like one more additional mask is required for prevent from the silicidation process. Okay, then we have a metal one layer. So metal one layer is like a normal layer. Okay, so metal one will be fabricated, then all the layers. So I just wanted to show you buried layer. So this is our buried layer. So buried layer is completely, you know, like underneath of our active region. Like this is our active gate, like 2 terminal gates are available. So we have a poly one and we have a poly two. The complete device is under N buried layer process. Okay, so this is our N buried layer process without any deep envelope. If we want to add any deep envelope, then we want to manually add one more additional ring. So those things will be explained in future. But initially, only N buried layer based structure I wanted to show you. So that's why N buried layer. So this is where N buried layer will be there. Inside the N buried layer, all the active devices will be there. Okay, then apart from that, we have these, you know, like different layers called HV, PVL. See, this is HV, this is high voltage PVL. So SH underscore P means this is P type implantation, high voltage P implantation. Then we have HVN. So HVN is also available here. So for the drain terminal, so on top of, you know, like the drain terminal, they have a high voltage N implantation devices. Okay, high implantation N, high voltage N implantation is also available. So that is called SH underscore N. So this is high voltage N implantation. So overall, if I added, overall, if you want me to show all the device, so the yellow color layer, this is our HV dummy. So this is our HV dummy layer. So the layer functionality and layer wise, you know, what is the reason for this HV envelope layer and what is the functionality of this HV envelope layer will be discussed. Okay, we will discuss later. But so this is how our entire LD MOSFET structure will be there. So this is our high voltage envelope layer. Okay, so this is our high voltage device. Apart from that, see, we have a default guard ring is available. So this is our body guard ring. So default, all the high voltage devices will consist this guard ring. So after this guard ring, we need to add our additional guard ring. So like N buried layer guard ring or a deep envelope guard ring, whatever guard ring is needed, we have to add manually. But this is our P cell. The P cells itself will contain a guard ring, and as well as the cross sectional view or the internal structure view will be like this. Okay, then body terminal. So this is also a body terminal. For example, if you want me to show this partitional layers RPO and as well as this poly, not poly, diffusion, see here, this is also act as a body terminal. Okay, so in between these two terminals, because you know LD MOSFETs are like asymmetrical design, so they want to make it as a symmetrical design. So if you want to keep a symmetrical design, they will keep like one more body terminal here. So this will be a source terminal, this will be a source terminal, and this will be your drain terminal, and this will be your drain terminal. Okay, so this is like a symmetrical structure. They are trying to make it as a symmetrical view. Okay, so this is how the fabrication process, you know, like will involve to convert like asymmetrical to asymmetrical. Okay, so this is the structure of asymmetrical to symmetrical structure. And then like if you start add everything, see by default the piece itself they have added poly contact. Poly is having a default contacts here. So let me show you the poly contacts. See here they have added poly contacts. Poly is already routed with M2. If you want to take any poly connection, then we have to start from the M2 routing. So it's manually, we don't need to add any poly cap for these devices. Okay, so these are like optionals. If you want to remove this poly contact, yes, we can remove and we can go for the M3 via or M4 via, whatever via is necessary. But PCL itself is contained gate contacts. Okay, by default we have a gate, you know, the both gates are connected together and we have a M2 routing. So in the typical MOSFET we don't have this like default gate contacts. We need to manually add the poly cap, end of the poly cap we need to manually add the gate terminal like poly to M1 via or M2 via. So we need to add and we need to do the routing. But here PCL itself, it's contained a gate routing. So this is like one more additional advantage. So apart from that, you know, there is no usage for this, you know, gate contact. So they have added PCL itself, they have added, that's all. So if you want we can use, if you don't want we can remove this. Okay, so this is the normal device, and we'll look into the one more type of device also. See, this is our another type of devices. So in this device we wanted to see the major difference, you know, like when compared to the previous design or previous layout and this design. See, we have a unburied layer here. Unburied layer is completely underneath of this active devices, and as we discussed earlier, this is our body terminal. So this internal terminal is our body terminal, and we have our source terminal, and we have our one more source terminal, and this is our drain terminal, and this is our drain terminal. But see, the distance between the drain to gate is like slightly extended. So this is called structured drain devices, because see here, the source to gate distance is very small, like 0.1 microns, but here the source terminal to the gate terminal distance, exactly from this layer to this layer, this is like 1.26 micrometers away, which is extended. So if the devices are working under very high voltage rating, like more than like 70 or 90 200 300 voltage rating, so these structured drain devices they are using. So source will be as closer as possible, like with 0.1 is the minimum DRC or minimum fabrication allowable distance from the active poly to the source and drain terminal. But here the drain terminal is completely stretched even for the left and right side. So let me open the previous layout also for your understanding. So I'll keep it in one side. See, this is how our typical, you know, like low voltage MOSFETs will be there. Okay, so this is how the structure of MOSFET. See, the distance for the source and gate, it's exactly equal. Okay, from the active gate to the gate area to the source area and as well as drain area, like this is 0.48 and this is also 0.48. okay, because this is a low voltage device, they don't want to, you know, like go for the high, they are not going to use this device for higher voltage rating. But here the drain terminal is completely stretched 1.26 micrometers away from the active gate region. So this is called stretched drain devices. So this is our typical device, whatever it is there in the right side, the second figure, this is our typical MOSFET. This is our LD MOSFET devices. So like fabrical method and as well as layout style, whatever, you know, in future if you want to do any layout design for this LD MOSFET, so you need to give more importance to the routing, and we will get so many DRCs with respect to these external layers. Okay, since this is higher voltage devices, higher voltage rating devices, we have to give more importance to the EM calculation and as well as routing. And if you want to maintain any matching pattern, are for this, you know, kind of LD MOSFET, then the work, you know, like when compared to the typical MOSFET to the normal, you know, like this kind of LD MOSFET, will take more time, and this need more experience, okay, to handle all the issues, okay. So then this is called a structured drain device. All the LD MOSFET devices, by default, all the LD MOSFET devices, the drain will be little stretched away from the active gate. Okay, source will be in the default with like the basic minimum DRC, but the drain terminal will be slightly extended from the active gate terminal. So this is called LD MOSFET fabrication design. Okay, this is one more kind of LD MOSFET design. Whereas in our library manager for higher voltage, see, we have one more like two NDA29GA3 unburied layer and MAC. So let me open and let me show you this structure also. See, this device is also like exactly look like a normal device, but the GERT terminal and other terminals, whatever it is there, see, the GERT terminal poly is also connected in top. See, poly is also like completely connected with the two left and right poly is also, you know, having a continuity between the same poly terminal, and as well as we have a high voltage N-well layer. So this is our high voltage N-well layer. In between this particular area, we don't have high voltage N-well. Okay, so these in between area, we don't have high voltage N-well. Apart from that, the complete area from here to here, it is completely filled with HVNVL, so which is nothing but high voltage NVL region. Inside of this particular area, we don't have HVNVL. Then we have our P implantation. So because here they are going to fabricate our body terminal. So body terminal, they don't want to create a high voltage NVL. Okay, so particularly in this area, the masking process is will not allow to implant the high voltage NVL here. Then we have a P implantation and as well as N implantation to the device, and we have a contacts. So let me show you one by one the contacts. Then we have a via. See, the gates are already having the gate contacted vias. Then we have a metal to routing, and as well as we have a VTDN. So I don't know what is the exact usage for this VTDN. So let me refer DRM and I'll upload in the one more part. Then as we discussed, like we have an unburied layer. So buried layer will be like formation of the buried layer will be like this. Then we have a SH P layer. This is nothing but our high voltage P implantation. Okay, so as we discussed earlier, we have our HVNVL. We have our HVNVL. Then I told you HVNVL will not be fabricated within this particular area. Then here we have a P implantation, which is nothing but our high voltage P implantation, because here we have our body terminal. So this is our body terminal, and this is our source terminal, and this is our source terminal. Okay, so on top of the source terminal and as well as our body terminal, they are fabricating high voltage P implantation. Okay, so this is like additional implantation layer, and they have a SH layer, that is our high voltage N implantation kind of layer. They are fabricated on top of this drain terminal. This is our drain terminal. Okay, on top of the drain terminal, they are fabricating SH underscore N layer, and on top of our source terminal and as well as our body terminal, the fabrication foundries are fabricating SH underscore P layer. Okay, then we have a HV dummy layer. So this is like high voltage dummy layer. So all visible layers will look like this exactly. So even though this device is also like drain is extended away from the device. See, this is our active gate. See, our poly. So from our poly to this drain terminal is completely extended. Okay, so this is also structured drain device. All the high voltage MOSFET like LD MOSFET, if you go to any kind of LD MOSFET, this drain will be always stretched from the active gate region. Okay, so this is like structured drain device. So finally, I wanted to show you how to add the guard ring for the unburied layer process. See, I'll take a high voltage MOSFET here. So this is my high voltage MOSFET. So view, I need to convert to layout. So then hide, I'm going to place my device here. Okay, so this is my device. Let me show you layer by layer. So this is my internal device. Okay, so this guard ring is, I need to reduce the guard ring size. Okay, so now we have our device, which is exactly located here. Okay, so let me show all the layers for your understanding. So this is our device. Okay, so in our device we have our poly gate. So this is our poly gate and this is our poly gate. This is our source terminal. Let me enable M1 also, and as well as contact. So this is our source terminal, and this is our source terminal, and this is our body terminal, and this is our drain terminal, and this is our drain terminal. Apart from that, we have our body terminal, so which is nothing but our local substrate. Okay, so this is our local substrate, so which is going to connect to our local body of the device. So next to this we have a deep envelope layer. So this is our deep envelope ring. Okay, so next to this deep envelope layer we have a n buried layer ring. So this is our buried layer ring. The second ring is our buried layer ring, and then at last ring, so this ring is our p substrate ring. So the last ring is our p substrate ring. So next to this our p substrate ring we have a n buried layer ring. So next to this n buried layer ring we have deep envelope ring. So next to this deep envelope ring we have our local substrate guard ring. So that is nothing but our body connection. So this is what we have discussed in the first slide, like four well fabrication based LD MOSFETs. Okay, this is four well. So this is first well, and this is our second well, and this is our third well, and this is our fourth well. So retrogenerate four well process. Okay, this is called a retrogenerate four well process. Then let me, you know, like highlight all the layers one by one. See, buried layer up to here. So I think we have already, you know, see, we have discussed in the cross-sectional view. Exactly inside the buried layer we have a deep envelope layer. So here we have our deep envelope ring. Next to the deep envelope ring we have our unburied layer ring. So which means our deep envelope layer is completely inside our buried layer. Our buried layer is going to end here. So then we have our local, you know, like global substrate, that is nothing but our p substrate. So then we have a dummy layer. So this HV dummy they are using for, you know, like for some other reason. And they have, see, NLVT layer. So I will explain whatever, you know, functionality of this layer I will explain in the next video, because again this duration of the video will take longer time. So that's why I just wanted to show you, you know, like how the guard ring structure will be fabricated in this four retrogenerated well based process. Then we have RPO layer. I think we have already discussed, like RPO layer will be fabricated here on top of the source and drain. So collectively, if I turn on all the device, this is how your LD MOSFET, you know, like single device of LD MOSFET with deep envelope and as well as n buried layer and as well as your global substrate and local substrate ring, totally four well process based LD MOSFET device is here. If you want to measure the device size, see, the device, you know, including the guard ring, it's like 50 into 50 micrometers. Okay, so 50 micrometer. Just imagine if you have a wafer which is, you know, contained like 8 inches or 12 inches to 15 inches. Okay, so normal 28 nanometer or normal devices, like even though if you take 90 nanometer or same 180 nanometer, like typical MOSFET, they will occupy only 10 × 10 micrometers, not even 10 × 10, it's like 2 micrometers to 3 micrometers including the ring. Okay, so maximum, worst case. Okay, so if you are, you know, using like more 16 multipliers or 32 multipliers and some, you know, like number of fingers and multipliers value, that will never come up to 50 micrometers of area. It will never occupy 50 micrometer distance. Okay, so let's, you know, even if you consider, if I try to keep it, you know, like the minimum DRC for this guard ring, because this DRC is like I have extended this guard ring for 5 micrometers and left and right. Suppose if I am try to avoid this 5 micrometers, suppose if the 5 micrometers I have removed and I have kept it as closer as possible, the minimum, you know, the DRC is 2 micrometers. Okay, so almost if I keep with the minimum DRC distance for all the guard ring and as well as this device, so this single unit device will take almost 40 to 45 micrometers or micron area. Okay, so this is how the big area occupied will be happened in the LD MOSFET. LD MOSFET devices will take huge area. Okay, just consider we have a single device which is, you know, occupying 40 micrometers of area. Then suppose if you have a LDO or if you have any other, you know, power devices like a differential pair amplifiers and some kind of devices, if you have a single block, a normal single sub blocks will take 200 to 300 micrometers area. Okay, I am talking about LNW area. So even more, more higher, like 400-500 micrometers area, a single blocks will take, because the individual device size itself huge. See, the individual devices. This is our individual device. Let me disable this unburied layer. See, this is our individual device. The individual device itself having a 13 into 21. Okay, which means like 21 cross 13. Okay, so 21 cross 13 micrometers of area the single device is occupying. Apart from that, we are going to add our deep envelope ring. So this is our deep envelope ring formation. Okay, so in this deep envelope ring formation, we have a buried layer ring formation. This is our buried layer ring. So next to that buried layer ring, we have our global substrate ring. That is our P substrate, or this is our global substrate ring. That is nothing but our P plus ring. Okay, so on, we have, you know, like LD MOSFET. So this is how the LD MOSFET structures will be there, and this is how the internal and cross-sectional rings will be there in the LD MOSFET design. So this is my initial video to just understand, you know, like LD MOSFETs and the four well retro generated well process based LD MOSFET. So in my future video, I'll try to show you how to do the matching pattern for these LD MOSFET and how to do the high power routing. Like, this is high voltage devices, so high voltage routings are like completely different from the normal routing. So I will explain to you in my future videos, like how to do the matching pattern for this LD MOSFET and how to add the guard ring and how to remove the DRCs and everything. I will explain in my future videos. So thanks for watching this video. I hope I have given some valuable information to you in this video. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends. For more details about this video, please contact us to my email ID and follow us on my Facebook page and Twitter page, and kindly subscribe our channel, and don't forget to click the bell button.